Ah, I see you have returned, students of the Force, and acolytes of the Dark Side. Welcome back to the Archives. Today, we are going to be opening another holocron revolving around the Sith, the ancient Dark Side order that was created by the Jedi in the Second Great Schism. The Sith were a brand of Force users that were always affiliated to the Dark Side. Using their emotions such as deep hatred, anger, and fury, fuel their power and lust for abilities, allowing them to often overcome and nearly destroy the Jedi Order outright, as Darth Sidious would do many millennia later. However, there is something we need to note about the Sith, the unique fact that many of them did not reach an old age. Many of the Rule of Two era Sith were killed by their apprentices in order to stake their claim as the new master and take on their own apprentice. Some of the ancient Sith were killed in combat in brutal sparring sessions. As is known, the greatest weakness of the Sith Order has always been the infighting, beings such as Ludo Kresh, King Adas, while living for very long amounts of time, never were able to rise up above the length of a few hundred years, due to the fact of the infighting and their eventual death. But today we are going to be inspecting the top 10 most longevious Sith, and figure out which 10 Sith had the longest age. Prepare as we venture into the galaxy. The number 10 position, we have Darth Plagueis the Wise, a character we have been covering extensively here on the channel as of late. Darth Plagueis the Wise is a legendary Mon Sith Lord who was head of Damask Holdings, a portion of the intergalactic Benkin clan. Darth Plagueis, while his date of birth was never specified, was speculated as being born between 147 to 127 BBY, meaning by the time of his death in 32 BBY, he would be nearly a century or well over a century old. While there are a multitude of contradictions from various novel statements claiming Plagueis was well over 100 years old in 67 BBY in human years, this was debunked in the James Luceno novel Darth Plagueis, personally my favourite Star Wars novel to ever exist, and one I highly recommend reading. Darth Plagueis extended his longevity using midichlorians, allowing himself to go unchanged and unaging, allowing himself to continue to run the intergalactic Benkin clan Damask Holdings, and he was attacked by Malani assassins, forcing him to don a respirator, despite his immense connection to the Force. However, even the wisest of the Sith had to fall down to someone, and coming in next, we have his own apprentice, Emperor Sheev Palpatine. Palpatine was born over 80 years before the Battle of Yavin, and was one of the most powerful Sith Lords to have ever have existed. Emperor Sheev Palpatine is the greatest Sith of all time, as he accomplished the Sith's lifelong goal of absolutely dominating the Jedi Order. A fearsome opponent in both lightsaber combat and in the Force, Sidious was a nigh unstoppable opponent. Using the Force and his uncontrolled mastery of lightsabers, as well as brute fury, to utterly overwhelm his opponents. In canon continuity, Darth Sidious lived to 37 BBY, where after this, Darth Sidious was killed on Exegol by Rey, and it cemented the final fall of the Sith. In Lynch's continuity, Palpatine was killed in 11 ABY, meaning he would be slightly younger, just about 2 decades, than he would be in canon, meaning we will be counting the canonical version, meaning Palpatine would have lived to the ripe old age of 117. A pure testament to the pure power of this character. Using essence transfer, he was capable of transferring his essence through various clone bodies such as Snoke and the one we see on Exegol to sustain his life perpetually. However, Darth Krayt, formerly known as Asherat Heh, outweighs him by a fair margin. The last great Sith Lord of the Legends timeline, Darth Krayt was the dark side match of Grandmaster Luke Skywalker and the insinuator of the One Sith ideology. Darth Krayt was stated to have lived several lifetimes, a testament to his immense power, and primarily the reason he became so formidable. Krayt studies as a Jedi before moving on to the ways of a bounty hunter and a Tusken, before finally descending down the dark path to become the Dark Lord of the Sith, one of the few people who Grandmaster Luke Skywalker genuinely feared. Darth Krayt was held in higher regard than beings such as Darth Vader, who were capable of defeating beings such as Mace Windu and Yoda just a year into his apprenticeship in the Galactic Empire. Born a few years before Anakin Skywalker, Krayt, at the time of his final death in 138 ABY, on The planet of Coruscant would be around the age of 188, meaning he's roughly 7 decades older than Sidious and Plagueis. However, Darth Krayt is nothing compared to the next instigator in our list, the next installment, being Lord Scourge. Lord Scourge was a Sith Lord who was widely discounted and discredited when considering some of the greatest Sith in history. Lord Scourge was one of the primary players in the Old Republic, with Lord Scourge instigating a numerous amount of events and foreseeing a vision that the hero of Tython, a Jedi regarded as the greatest of his age, would kill the Sith Emperor Vitiate, or at least briefly incapacitate him. Lord Scourge was a ferocious Sith warrior, and after killing Mitra Suri, after briefly joining her and Revan in fighting the Sith Emperor, using deception in order to keep Revan and Mitra's cause alive, he faked his own death. With Mitra being killed, Scourge cemented his place as the Emperor's most trusted confidant, above even the likes of the Dark Council. Scourge's longevity, extending over 3 centuries, can be contracted back to a ritual. In this ritual, the Emperor performed a miniature version of the ritual he did 1,000 years prior on Nathema, where which he transferred his immortality over to Scourge, meaning as long as the Emperor of the Sith lived, Scourge would also live indefinitely, allowing him to hone his dark side skills. However, coming in next, we had the Prodigal Knight himself. We have Revan. Revan, a man of many paths. Revan was known to have lived over 370 years. Being that Revan was one of the longest-lived Sith and Jedi in history, falling short to just the likes of beings such as Grandmaster Yoda and Krook. Darth Revan, now known as Revan, whose longevity can be attributed to the fact that the Sith Emperor Vitiate, in the aforementioned exposure and excerpt that I recited, Lord Scourge, as I stated, ventured with Mitra Suric to Jormund Kaas, as well as Revan, to fight Sith Emperor Vitiate and dethrone him. However, once Scourge saw it was hopeless, he betrayed them and allowed the cause to live on through his usage of manipulation with regards to the hero of Tython, a legendary Jedi. Revan was locked up, and Vitiate continued to sustain his life for the next 3 centuries, meaning he would be older than even Lord Scourge due to the fact he was born before him. Revan lived several lifetimes, and in the end, though he wanted nothing more than to murder Vitiate, that was a goal he was ultimately never able to accomplish. Not even Revan could stop the Sith Emperor. Coming in next, we have Naga Sadow, a character which I wish to explore more on the series in our channel and update our archives about. Naga Sadow was a legendary Sith who started the Great Hyperspace War, one of the most cataclysmic failures in Sith history. After taking over the mantle of Dark Lord of the Sith from the Golden Age of the Sith in Marka Ragnos and dueling Ludo Kresh, Naga Sadow was a master of sorcery, being able to generate solar flares and cause supernovas, making him in the top 20 most powerful Sith of all time, perhaps even debatably the top 10, although personally this is not something I necessarily believe. Naga Sadow lived multiple centuries, living up to the age of over 600 years old, due to the fact he started the Great Hyperspace War in 5000 BBY, and was born likely before this, due to the fact he was quite old when he dueled Ludo Kresh, and he would then go on to suspend himself in stasis in Yavin 4 until freed Nad, an ambitious Jedi who wanted to learn the dark ways, came and completely obliterated his spirit after learning all he needed from his ghostly master, meaning his 6th century lifespan stops here. The number 4 position goes to Emperor Vitiate, Valkorion, Tenebrae. While many of you would be thinking that he'd be ranked number 1 due to his outstanding longevity, we have chosen to place him here due to a numerous amount of beings who've lived for several more millennia than he has. Tenebrae, Vitiate, Valkorion, whatever you wish to call him, lived several millennia. Vitiate lived a millennia as the Emperor of the Sith, extending his lifespan by using the Nathemic ritual and the ritual on Zios, allowing him to preserve his spirit immortality, using essence transfer as he unlocked from the holocron of Darth Endedu, and then the wisdom that was passed down. He was able to transfer his consciousness into other clone bodies, and even implant his consciousness in infants, such as he most famously did with Valkorion. Of course, Tenebrae would later on be killed by the hero of Tython, as I stated earlier, with the machinations of Lord Scourge finally becoming complete. Later on, he would go on to forge the Eternal Empire under the guise of the immortal Emperor Zakul Valkorion, although Valkorion's own family and the Outlander, the rising star of the Force, eventually entombed this ancient entity to the world of Chaos, where he suffered for eternity. Coming at the number 3, we have Mark Aragnos, who lived for over 5 millennia. While this is a highly contested debate, we are counting Sith spirits, or at least beings who preserve their spirit using various rituals, such as Mark Aragnos. Mark Aragnos was able to preserve his spirit due to his immense Force connection, and was widely regarded as one of the greatest Jedi and Sith warriors and most powerful Force users to have ever existed. Meaning he is in the top 20 for sure of the most powerful Star Wars characters, period. Mark Aragnos was the pioneer of the Golden Age of the Sith, and while he died while he was just over a century old in his physical body, in 5000 BBY, he was able to reanimate his spirit, keeping it chained to the physical world by binding it to his own tomb. Mark Aragnos would return many millennia later, during the ABYs and during the era of Luke's Jedi Praxium, where Jedi Knight Jaden Kor and Tavian Axis would duel with Mark Aragnos' spirit, possessing the latter. Although Mark Aragnos was thwarted, he still remains to this day. Coming in at the number 2, we have Darth Ndedu, the creator of many dark side techniques that we know today. Darth Ndedu was a legendary Sith Lord and one of the most formidable and intelligent Sith to have ever lived. Darth Ndedu created the Essence Transfer Technique, which would go on to become a staple of all Vitiate, Palpatine, Darth Ndedu, and many others, including Darth Krayt. Darth Ndedu was a master of knowledge and Sith works, and while he lived for several millennia regardless, Darth Ndedu lived for several centuries, living for several centuries in his physical body on Prakath, until eventually his own paranoia overcame him, and he created a tomb, which he encased himself in with all his knowledge to ensure it would never be stolen. Many millennia later, it was awoken by Darth Wyrlock, who desired to seek the knowledge so that way he could help his master Darth Krayt overcome his Yuuzhan Vong Gross in the One Sith Order, remaining fiercely loyal despite all the secrets of the dark side, evidently suggesting towards overthrowing Krayt. Ndedu would rather die with all the knowledge he had acquired than live and one day see his fall to his enemies. In the end, he was over 6 millennia old. Now finally, at the number 1, we have Carnus Myrrh, one of the founding Sith Lords. Carnus Myrrh was a legend in the Star Wars galaxy, as a being whose power rivaled an early version of Darth Sidious, who Darth Vader even considered would prove a match for Sidious if he used his Myrrh talisman. Carnus Myrrh was an exceptionally skilled and formidable Sith Lord. While his Myrrh talisman was primarily what he was known for, Carnus Myrrh was effortlessly capable of dominating the minds of some of the Jedi's most formidable warriors. Myrrh was capable of living for several centuries due to the creation of his Myrrh talisman by Zozan, one of the founding Sith Lords of the Order of the Sith Lords on Korriban in 7000 BBY, meaning that Carnus Myrrh would be even over 7000 years old. Carnus Myrrh's spirit was eventually destroyed by Cade Skywalker in 137 ABY, after contending with both Darth Krayt, Cade Skywalker, and many, many others, proving his immense power. In the end, Carnus Myrrh lived for many, many millennia, far more than anyone else, even Darth Ndedu, living for over 7,300 years. He truly deserves the number one spot. And that's our list. Be sure to tell us if we have missed any. While I highly believe this is the most comprehensive list, go check out others' lists if you believe their list is better, or if you can just find a list that is very similar to ours. I'm truly very intrigued by the age of Sith Lords, and the fact that multiple Sith Lords never reached their full age gap due to the treachery and infighting of the Sith Order. That's all from me, and this is where our holocron concludes, students. Beware of the Dragon of Zakul. And remember, the Force will be with you always.